Well, transporting dogs by air usually means putting them in a cage in a plane's cargo hold. Not so with the new airline, which is set to have its maiden flight on Thursday. Now, Bark Air promises to transport dogs of all sizes and their people in comfort and style. That means luxury, such as a sunlit waiting lounge filled with treats and toys, an onboard spa for pups, as well as a menu catered for canine. Currently, Bark Air routes include flights between New York, Los Angeles, and London. The price for a one-way international flight for one dog and its human companion, $8,000, and $6,000 for a domestic trip. Concerns are raised over the Philippine Energy Department's directive to increase biodiesel blends in diesel starting October. Alvin El Chico reports.
The Energy Department has mandated an increase in the biodiesel content on diesel from the current 2% to 3% starting October this year and up to 5% until 2026. In the first year, the estimated impact is an increase of around 26 centavos per liter. For gasoline, the DOE has allowed oil firms to voluntarily sell a higher ethanol blend of 20% or E20 aside from the current 10%. According to the DOE, the price of E20 is way lower than the current gasoline products.
Kung i-implement niya yung noong March ang 20%, mas mababa siya ng 3 pesos ang 21 centavo per liter.
But some experts have alerted vehicle owners on the potential impact of higher biofuels content.
Modern engine kasi maraming plastic and rubber components yan eh. Ang ethanol kasi masama epekto sa mga ganyan, ano, lumulutong at lumalambot, no? So may impact yan dun sa durability ng sasakyan.
Sa diesel, pagka sa cold temperature, may tendency na mag-gel yung fuel, which is magbabara siya dun sa fuel filter, sa mga injectors. Mas nakaka-absorb ng water yung sa ethanol, especially yung mga nagko-collect ng mga sasakyan na nakaparada lang, may ethanol, then nakagarahe lang. So yun yung mas pro na if ever na may mga metal content dun sa fuel tank hanggang fuel line, may chance na magkaroon mga corrosion.
ABS-CBN has tried to ask the Chamber of Automotive Manufacturers of the Philippines, but the group has not responded. The DOE advises vehicle owners to consult their manual if the car or motorcycle can take higher biofuels content. Shell Pilipinas says it will comply with the mandatory higher biodiesel content, but the company needs to study the feasibility of selling E20 in the Philippines.
Kailangan ni iangat ang ating storage capacities. Kailangan i-calibrate namin yung in-blend equipment namin sa mga terminals. At huli, kailangan namin tingnan yung kung gaano kahanda yung mga stasyon namin.
Sea Oil says it will also further study if it can sell E20 in selected stations nationwide within the year. Clean Fuel, on the other hand, says there is a need to consider the additional expenses in constructing separate tanks for the E20 blend for gasoline. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.
Retail giant SM plans to get off the ground 10 to 15 grocery stores in provincial areas this year. Now, this is part of its target to reach over 350 stores nationwide. SM says for the first half of the year, it plans to open 3 stores, which will be located in Davao Oriental, Bulacan, and Mindoro. It notes the new stores will support homegrown small businesses by providing them with opportunities to showcase their products. SM currently has dozens of super and hypermarket branches and over 200 Save More stores.